गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर गुड एंड स्टेइंग एट योर होम सेफली। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टिल 25 पेज नंबर आई हैड 24 पेज नंबर आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू द स्टोरी। सो आई विल गिव यू अ क्विक रिव्यू अगेन सो दैट इफ एनी स्टूडेंट हैड मिस दोज वीडियोज ही कैन लाइक अंडरस्टैंड द चैप्टर बाय गिविंग बाय लिसनिंग दिस quick summary of the chapter which I am going to tell you. So there was a student, there was a kingdom of fools. In this kingdom, both the kings and the ministers were idiot. As they reversed the they reversed everything and denied justice to their people. Like they changed day into night and night into day. They had ordered their people to sleep during the day and work only after dark. So if anyone who is disobeyed this order would be put to death. So the people because of the fear did accordingly what the king and the minister told them to do. So one day two men, means a guru and his disciple, visited the kingdom and found everything reversed. Why? Because they were surprised to see people sleep in the broad daylight and when it was the evening time, everyone became active. Even the cattle, means all the cows and buffaloes also very active, and the dogs are also very active. Their surprise doubled when they went to the market and found that everything was the same, a single doodoo. And doodoo is what? Your local currency of the kingdom. So the guru and his disciple were happy because the system allowed them to buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. The guru was a wise person, so he told his disciple that he would not be safe for them to stay in the kingdom of fools. But the disciple was not ready to leave the place, and so the guru left the kingdom and the disciple stayed there because everything was good and cheap there. And being a great foodie, he ate. He started feeling every day and became fat in few days. Now, the one day a thief broke into a rich merchant's house by making a big hole in the wall. But as he was going out with the stolen things, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. Now what happened? The brother of the thief came running to the king and pleaded him to punish the merchant for not building a good and strong wall. So the merchant was brought before the king. Now the king heard the case and found him, means the merchant, guilty to the thief's spot death. So the merchant put the blame on the bricklayer who had built the wall. Now the bricklayer pleaded the king to punish the dancing girl who distracted his attention by going up and down that street all day with her anklet jingling. Now the dancing girl is an old woman who was brought to the court. So she put the blame on the goldsmith. She told the king that she had given some gold to the goldsmith to make some jewelry for her. But he delayed the work and made her walk up and down to his house several times. Now the goldsmith was produced before the king. After hearing the accusation against him, he said that he had to give some gold to the goldsmith to make the jewelry of her. But he delayed the work and made her walk up and down so many times because the goldsmith was busy in making the rich merchant's order first, as there was a wedding ceremony in his family. So it was therefore he made the dancing girl came to his door many times. Now the king asked the name of the merchant. He was none other than the merchant whose wall had fallen on the thief. The merchant blamed his father who had ordered the jewelry. Now, but the father was no more in this world, so it was decided by the king and the minister to punish the merchant in his place. Now a man was searched for. So a new stake was ordered to be ready for the execution, but the merchant was too thin to fit into that stake. So a fat man was searched for. The servant's eye fell on the disciple who had flattened himself for months on bananas and rice and wheat and ghee. So he pleaded the king that he was innocent but of no use. While he was waiting for death, he remembered his guru who saw everything in his vision. So he was blessed with magic power. Who? The guru was blessed with a magic power. So he arrived at once to save his disciple. He whispered something in his disciple's ear. Then he requested the king to put him to the stake first. When the disciple heard this, he said that he was brought there first, so he should be put to death first. Now, till this, I have completed my explanation. This is still 24th page number. Now, I will start with the 25th page number. When the disciple heard this, he understand and began to clamor, "Me first. You brought me here first. Put me to death first, not him." So, as I already told you that Guru had whispered something in his ear. So, now when they were finally taken to the courtyard last time of the king, the Guru said that who is greater, Guru or a disciple? So, king said that Guru. So, then he said that then you should put me on the stake first. But after hearing this, the disciple said that no, you have brought me first here, so you should put me on that stake first. Now the guru and the disciple now got into fight about who should go first. The king was puzzled by the behavior. He asked the guru, "Why do you want to die? We choose him because we needed a fat man for the stake." Now the guru and his disciple started a fake fighting in front of the king. Now the king was puzzled, as he was fooled. So he was very much like puzzled why both of them are fighting for a death. So the king asked the guru, "Why do you want to die first? We had chosen your disciple for a death because for execution, basically, because he was fat. So you shouldn't ask me such question. Put me to death first," replied the guru. But the guru said that you should not ask such a question. Bas mujhe, you just put me to the death first. "Why? There's some mystery here. As a wise man, you must make me understand." Now the king said that no, you just tell me, there should be some mystery why you want to go first on the stake. So Will you promise to put me to death if I tell you?" asked the guru. The king gave him his Solomon word. Now Solomon means serious word. And the guru took him aside out of the servant's earshot and whispered to him, "Do you know why we want to die right now, the two of us?" So what happened? The guru played a trick. And he said to the guru, king that, "Okay, if I tell you the truth, will you give me a permission to go for a death to that stake first?" He said, "Okay, seriously," he had given his word that, "Yes, I will put you first on the death." So what guru said, guru just took him from the earshot of the servant. मतलब कि जो कान जिस पे जहाँ पर वो कोई और उनकी बातें ना सुन पाए. So he just took him and he said that you know why we both want to go to that stake first. We have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. That stake is the stake of the God of justice. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whoever dies on it first will be reborn as the king of this country, and whoever goes next will be the future minister of this country." So what he played a trick and he said to the king that we had traveled so many countries, so many cities, but we had never visited this place and we never met a king and a minister like you. This stake is a stake of a God, justice of a God, and whosoever is gone first to on that stake will be reborn as a king in that kingdom, and the second person who will go on that stake will reborn as a minister in that kingdom. And we are sick of our
ascetic life, it would be nice to enjoy ourselves as a king and minister for a while. Now keep your word, my lord, and put us to death. Me first remember.
So he said that we are afraid of our ascetic life. Ascetic means जो मैंने आपको बताया था ना, that is your the person who is indulged in the scared that is a basically a saint or a the guru the means who's always follow the religious things. So he just said that he is afraid of the ascetic life and he want to be born in the kingdom and want to be rule as a king and minister again. So just put me on the death first, and you have given us a word. Now the king was now thrown into deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. So he needed time. So he ordered the execution postponed to the next day and talked in secret with his minister. Now the king, after listening to this fake story made by the guru, was came into a deep thought and he postponed the execution. Means he postponed the death of the execution of the guru and disciple, and he said that we need some time, and he went to a minister and he have a secret talk with them. It is not right for us, because he don't want to lose his kingdom. He just want to be reborn as a king and rule the kingdom again. Now it's not the right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next time. Let's go on the stake ourselves and we will reborn as a king and minister again. Holy men do not tell lies, he said, and the minister agreed. So when he started talking with his minister, he said that holy man never tells a lie, and he said that whoever is gone first on that thing will reborn as a king and the second will reborn as a minister. So we should not hand over our kingdom to any other person. So I will go first on the stake and you will go second on that stake. Now next, so he told the executioner, we will send the criminal tonight. When the first man comes to you, you put him to death first, then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders, don't make any mistakes. Now the king asked the servant, means executioner, that he will send the first person tonight, and you have to put that person on that stake first and the second with the same thing, and you have to follow my order, don't make any mistake. That night the king and his minister went secretly to the prison, released the guru and the disciple, disguised themselves as the two, and as arranged beforehand with loyal servants, were taken to the stake and promptly executed. Now that night what happened, the king and minister went to the prison and they just released the guru and disciple, and they were on the place of guru and the disciple, and they one by one on that stake for the execution. Now when the bodies were taken down to be thrown to crows and vultures, the people panicked. They saw before them the dead body of the king and the minister. The city was in confusion. Now what happened next? When the bodies were taken down to be thrown to crows and vultures, the people got panicked. Why? Because they panic means they got afraid that now they were dead. Who will rule the kingdom? Means there was no king and there was no minister. So they were very much confused. All night they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Mourned means they were laminated. They were confused. They were very much confused. What would be happen to our kingdom? Like, who is going to rule our kingdom? So all night they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave town unnoticed. So some people thought of guru and disciple and they just gone to that place where they were going to leave the kingdom, and without telling any everyone. So we people need a king and a minister, said the said someone. Others agree. They begged the guru and the disciple to be the king and the their minister. It didn't take many arguments to pursue the disciple, but it took longer to pursue the guru. So some of the people said that we want a king and a minister, and we want you to rule our kingdom. So everyone said that yes, we want you as a king and your disciple as a minister. So the argument was there was a long argument with the guru, and it was very long argument to settle him as a king. But where this disciple agreed on the to be minister very soonly, but it will take a long time to agree as a king for a guru. Now, but what happened it after that? They finally agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and the silly ministers on the condition that they could change all the old laws. But they said that they will be a minister and kingdom. They will be a minister and the king again, but on one condition, that they will change all the old laws. And what was the old law? That from then on night would again be night and day would again be day, and you could get anything for a doo doo, and you could get nothing for a doo doo. It become like any other place, like not a, if you are going to buy a dozen of banana, so you have to pay a single doo doo, and if you are going to buy a 5 kg of rice, then also you will buy a you will give a single doo doo. So that these two laws should be changed. So the what are the two important laws? That was the first, the day is changed into the night is changed into day, and day is changed into night, like the other places. In the day you all have to work, and in night you all have to sleep, and you will not get anything in a single doo-doo. So these are this is the story, and I guess you all have got the story. Tomorrow I will be discussing the question answers first with you all in WhatsApp group, as well as on a Gmeet class, like section GHINJ. I have a Gmeet class. So just write down the student, just write down the question, just write down the answers, and when I'll ask you in the WhatsApp group, you all have to send in a voice note. So I will be sending you the question page, means I will send you the screenshot of the question. So just go through that question, write down those answers in your rough copy, and I will be discussing the answers with you all, as well as I will give you a short summary again, and those your question answers with you all, like discuss the question answers in the video also, as well as in the WhatsApp group. So I'll discuss the question answer first in the WhatsApp group, then I'll send you the video. Thank you, class. Stay safe, and just read out the chapter again and do the question answers. Thank you, students. Take care and bye-bye.